In this video, we're going to complete the KutaSoftware Infinite Calculus free worksheet evaluating limits, and that's evaluating limits by direct evaluation. And quickly, there's a few theorems that I want to review. And these are theorems all for limits. So we'll have three theorems dealing with the limits of, our first is going to be linear equations or linear functions. Then we're going to go over the theorem for polynomials or polynomial functions, and then rational functions. The limits of linear functions theorem says that, now we're talking about slope-intercept form, so y equals mx plus b. If we have the limit of f of x as x approaches a, then that's going to equal f of a. The limit of f of x as x approaches a equals f of a. And if we're talking about slope-intercept form, that would be m times a plus b as opposed to m times x plus b. Now for polynomial functions, if we have a polynomial function p of x, the limit of p of x as x approaches a is going to be equal to p of a. And then lastly, for rational functions, the limit as x approaches a of, for rational function, we'll have p of x divided by q of x. That limit will equal p of a over q of a as long as q of a does not equal 0. So this is for when q of a does not equal 0, because remember, we cannot divide by 0. So if you notice that in each of these, we're essentially taking whatever value that x is approaching and just plugging it in to our functions. And that's going to give us the answer of our limit. Hence, direct evaluation. So let's jump in at number one. We're evaluating each limit, and number one is the limit of 5 as x approaches negative 1. So remember, we can think of this as the limit of f of x, because it's a linear equation, as x approaches a, but this linear equation is actually just a constant. So if we take negative 1, that's equal to a in this case, and plug it in for f of a, f of negative 1 is just going to be 5. So 5 is our solution in number 1. Let's move on to number 2. In number 2, by direct evaluation, this limit is going to equal f of negative 5 halves because it's a linear equation. So we're going to take negative 5 halves, our a value, and just plug that in for x. So we'll have negative, or the opposite of negative 5 halves, plus 2. So that's going to be a positive 5 halves plus 2, but as opposed to adding that to 2 as a whole number, I'm going to add it to 2 in terms of 2, which is 4 over 2, because 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. Now you can see I have a common denominator. 5 plus 4 is 9, so I'll have 9 over 2, or 9 halves, as my solution in number 2. In number 3, we have a polynomial, and remembering our limits polynomials theorem, it says that the limit of p of x, our polynomial, as x approaches a equals p of a. So what we're going to do for this, just like in the linear equations, we're taking 2 and plugging that value in for x. Direct evaluation. So we'll have 2 cubed minus 2 squared minus 4. 2 cubed is 8, and we're subtracting 2 squared, which is 4, and then subtracting 4 again. 8 minus 4 is 4, and 4 minus 4 is 0. So 0 is our solution in number 3. Direct evaluation, we're taking that value that x is approaching, which based on our theorems, we represented with the variable a, and we're going to be plugging that in. So we'll have negative 1 squared over 2 plus 2 times 1 plus 4. Negative 1 squared over 2 is negative 1 half. We're adding that to 2 because 2 times 1 is 2, and then we're adding that to 4. So we have negative 1 half plus, writing 2 and 4 with a denominator of 2, we'll have 4 over 2 plus 8 over 2, because 4 divided by 2 is 2, and 8 divided by 2 is 4. Now I can add those numerators together. Negative 1 plus 4 plus 8 is going to be a positive 11, and that's all over 2. So 11 halves is our solution in number 4. And number 5, still using direct evaluation, we're going to plug 3 in for x and solve. So we'll have the opposite of the square root of 3 plus 3, which equals negative or opposite of the square root of 3 plus 3, which is 6. And we cannot simplify any further. So that's our solution for number 5. For number 6, we're going to be plugging 3 halves in for x this time and solving. So we have the opposite of the square root of 2 times 3 halves plus 4. So that's going to be the opposite or negative square root of 2 times 3 halves. The 2's will cancel out because 2 times 3 over 2 will have 2 divided by 2, which is 1. So that's going to leave me with 3. So I have 3 plus 4 within that radical. So negative square root of 3 plus 4, which is 7, is my solution in number 6. In number 7, you can see that we have a rational limit, or a limit of a rational function. The limit of p of x over q of x as x approaches a is going to be equal to p of a over q of a. And remember that q of a cannot equal 0, because if it does, we'll be dividing by 0, which is undefined. So again, we're simply going to take that a value and plug it in for our function. So a in this case is 1, so we're taking 1 and plugging that in for x. So I'll have the opposite, or negative, 1 minus 4 all over 1 squared minus 6 times 1 plus 8. 1 minus 4 is negative 3. So negative 3 is a positive 3. So I have positive 3 over 1 squared is 1 minus 6 times 1 is minus 6 plus 8. So that's going to be 3 over 1 minus 6 is negative 5. And negative 5 plus 8 is a positive 3. 3 divided by 3 equals 1. So 1 is the limit of f of x as x approaches 1. For number 8, again, I'm taking what x is approaching, our a value, and plugging it in for x and solving. So we'll have the opposite, or negative, 3 halves minus 3 all over 3 halves squared plus 3 halves plus 1. Now for my numerator, I'm going to simplify by writing 3 over a common denominator of 2. So I'll have negative 3 halves minus 6 over 2, because 6 divided by 2 equals 3. And in my denominator, I'll distribute this exponent of 2. So I'll have 3 squared over 2 squared, which is 9 over 4, or 9 fourths. I'm adding 3 halves to that, and then I'm adding 1. So now in my numerator, negative 3 halves minus 6 halves is going to be a negative 9 halves. And in my denominator, I'm going to write everything with a denominator of 4 so that I can simplify. So that'll be 9 fourths plus, I'll multiply this fraction by 2 over 2. So that will be 6 fourths. And then for 1, I'll multiply that by 4 over 4 to be 4 over 4. So simplifying further, I'll have negative 9 halves all over 9 plus 6 plus 4 is going to be 19 over 4. And remember, dividing by a rational or dividing by a fraction is the same as multiplying by that reciprocal. So this is going to equal -9/2 times 4/19. Now from here, I can multiply my numerators together and multiply my denominators together and then simplify, or I can simplify as I go along because I know that 2 goes into 4 evenly. 4/2 is a positive 2, so I'll just have 2 remaining in the numerator. So now I'll be able to multiply -9 to 2 to give me -18, and that's 19. So -18/19 is my solution in number 8. For number 9, we're finding the limit of the sine of x as x approaches pi. So in this case, we're going to be taking pi, our value of a, and plugging it in for x. So this is going to equal the sine of pi. And if you want me to draw out the unit circle, I'll go ahead and do so quickly. Here's a rough sketch of the unit circle. Here's 0, going 180 degrees, or to -1, and the x, we're at a radian of pi. And remember, x and y were cosine, comma, sine. So here is the point, -1, 0. Therefore, the sine of pi is equal to 0. So 0 is our solution in number 9. Moving on to number 10, we're finding the limit of 2 times the cosine of x as x approaches 3π/4. So we're going to plug 3π/4 in for x. So that's going to be 2 times the cosine of 3π/4. And 3π/4 on our unit circle occurs at this point here. That is 3π/4. Which in terms of x, y, that's going to be -√2/2, comma, √2/2. And we're dealing with cosine, so we're looking at the x value, which is -√2/2. So the cosine of 3π/4 is -√2/2. So we're going to have 2 times -√2/2. And notice that 2 divided by 2 is 1, so my 2's will cancel out to leave me with -√2 for the limit of 2 times the cosine of x as x approaches 3π/4 in number 10, -√2. Now on to the critical thinking questions. In number 11, it says, give an example of a limit that evaluates to 4. Let's do a linear function. So we'll have the limit of f of x as x approaches a equals f of a. So we need to find some function that as x approaches a, we can plug a in and get f of a equal to 4. One easy way to do this is to say that f of x equals x. So then we have the limit of x, but now we just have to see what x is approaching in order to get f of a equal to 4. And plugging 4 in for x will give us that our function at 4 is equal to 4. So we'll have the limit of x as x approaches 4. That is equal to 4. Another example would be, let's say we just make this a constant, and the constant is 4. So we have the limit of 4 as x approaches, well, this can be as x approaches really any real number. We could have this approaching 100, but because it's a constant, whatever value you plug in for x, we're always going to be at 4 in the y. Or 4 is our value of f of x. So that's just one more example. Let's move on to number 12. In number 12, it says to give an example of a limit of a quadratic function where the limit evaluates to 9. So we're dealing with a polynomial, so we know that the limit of p of x as x approaches a, based on that theorem, that's going to be p of a. That limit will equal p of a. So we need it to evaluate to 9. So P of A must equal 9. Let's do one of the simplest quadratics for P of X. Let's say that P of X equals X squared. So now we need to see what value we need to plug in order to get P of A equals to 9. So we're saying that P of A, or A squared, in this case, if we were to plug A in for X, that equals 9. So now we'll just take the square root of both sides to get that A equals a positive 3, or A could also equal negative 3. Now when writing our limit, I'll say that the limit of P of X, which is X squared, as X approaches, I'll go ahead and use positive 3, that limit is equal to 9. So the limit of X squared as X approaches 3 is a positive 9. Also, the limit of x squared as x approaches negative 3 is also a positive 9. So there's one example of a limit of a quadratic function where the limit evaluates to 9. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below, or if you've come up with your own unique examples, put those in the comments below as well. Also, while you're at it, give me a thumbs up on this video, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your classmates if you think other people will find it useful. If you want more ways to support me, become a patron. Go to maemap.com, that's M-A-E-M-A-P.com, to figure out more.